I'm so sorry to tell you this, but, you're dead. Yeah. I didn't want to be the bearer of bad news, but unfortunately that is my job, so, yeah. But don't worry, you're a ghost. I am also a ghost, so, we can be ghosts together. My name is Sabrina, and no, not like the teenage witch. I get that a lot, so, just want to make that clear. If I were a teenage witch, I wouldn't be dead. Okay. I would have done a spell, and I would not be dead. So, anyways, you're probably wondering why I'm here welcoming you into the afterlife, right? Yeah, I thought so. So, like I said, you're dead. But no worries, it's not as bad as it seems. So since you're a ghost, you get to haunt wherever you want. It's kind of awesome, honestly. So I'm here to interview you and go over kind of what to expect now that you're going into ghost life, the afterlife. But also, I want to go through some questions and kind of figure out where is the best place for you to haunt. Is that cool? Awesome. Okay. So, first things first. I am not an angel. I mean, like, I kind of am an angel, but not really. I mean, I wasn't the best person on earth. Like, I wasn't the worst, you know? But not the best, no. So, I've been put into this position fairly recently. So bear with me because I am still learning a few things. So yeah. How did I die? Oh well, I died in kind of like a Final Destination way. Have you seen those movies? Yeah. Okay, remember the tanning bed one? Yeah, that was based off of me. Yeah, super embarrassing. So, yeah, here we are. So, yeah. Oh, no, I can't tell you how you died. But what I can tell you is that when you die, everybody's matched to an angel. Like myself or like somebody else, based off of personalities. So I'm gonna guess that you probably died in a bit of an embarrassing way yourself. You'll probably remember down the line, yeah, you'll probably be like out doing spooky stuff and all of a sudden remember how you died, and it will be very shocking and jarring for you. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, I actually don't look like this, really. I have to put on a lot of makeup, because I'm actually quite pale. You know, being a ghost and whatnot. So, I thought I was pale before, but, I'm very, very pale now. So, anywho. So I have some questions here. If that's okay with you, can go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and help you figure out where you should haunt. So super fun. We like to place everybody in some place that they're happiest. So I mean, you have to haunt somewhere. Might as well put you somewhere you're gonna enjoy. Am I right? So do you have any questions before we get started? Yeah, I can't actually answer that. I can't tell you a whole lot. That's not really my job. You'll find somebody else down the line to do that for you. But here's some D that I can spell. God is a woman. Who'd have thought? I thought that. I definitely thought that. It makes sense to me. But, oh, and yeah, and when you pass on to the next step, it's kind of like Beetlejuice. Have you ever seen that movie? I'm just kidding. It's not like Beetlejuice. I'm just kidding. But God is a woman, though, and she does have a great sense of humor, in case you couldn't tell. Yeah, the current Well, you shouldn't fear anything because you're dead now. So, nothing can hurt you. So, okay, so I'm gonna put nothing, okay. So what's like your aesthetic? Do you kind of like spooky mansions? What's your kind of, do you like big houses, cozy houses, cottage type, cities, small towns? Okay. What about your color scheme? Do you have a preferred color scheme? Yeah, okay. It's kind of basic, but okay. Okay, let's see here. Do you like mountains? Yeah, okay. Do you like the ocean? Yeah. It's a bummer, but the cool thing about being a ghost is that you literally get to go wherever you want. It's awesome. You don't have rent. You don't have to have a job. You don't have any obligations whatsoever. And you can literally spy on like anybody. Yeah, it's amazing. Honestly, once you get used to it, it's not that bad. I know it seems like all doom and gloom and everything like that, but it's really not that bad. It took me some getting used to, but I mean, now that I'm here, I'm getting the hang of it. Yeah, I mean, I don't get to fly, which I kind of thought was like something that you get to do, but apparently it's not something that you get to do. Really bummed about that, so yeah. Anywho, so yeah. I really am sorry that, you know, you died. It's a bummer, for sure, for sure. But, we can be friends, and I mean, like, I have multiple places that I haunt, so we'll definitely run into each other. Yeah, and you'll also make tons of friends. Yeah, I mean, you're like me, and we're super cool, and every other ghost wants to hang out with us, so, yeah. Don't worry, you'll get used to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and send you off to your next location. There's gonna be somebody else that's gonna kind of actually go over the more specific rules of being a ghost and blah blah blah. The only things that I'm gonna tell you right off the bat is, even though you're a ghost and you're gonna technically haunt someplace, you cannot actually hurt anybody, so don't do that. I know, big buzzkill, right? So that's really all you need to know. That's really the only important part. But the next ghost is going to help you out, so they can answer your questions more than I can. So, anyways, I think that's all I have for you. Oh, and here is your key. What is it for? Well, it's to get into the locations that you're going to haunt. So here you go. I'm just kidding. You're a ghost. You can walk through anything. You don't need a key. I know, I'm hilarious. Okay.